Hi, in this video, I will create a simple attendance app. This app functions as a tool for attendance that can be used in the office or at school, for example. In this attendance app, I will create a distance validation feature. The validation location so that user must move closer to the site with a minimum distance in meters that we will set. When the user is on the site, the user are required to take a selfie picture. The user can also check out when they want to leave the site. Okay, let's get straight to the project. First, I will create a new project with name is user attendance. Then, next step, I will create it. Build authentication. With email or password. Then Firestore database to store our data. Then the storage, because we will store the selfie picture. Okay, now move the project setting at Firebase at Flutterflow IO as editor. Then click additional permission settings. And as usual, we have to add two more rules into Firebase at Flutterflow.io user. First thing is service management admin and cloud function admin. And then copy the project ID and paste in Flutterflow and click out the generate config files. Okay, now we go to flood to flow. I will create an authentication from we contact from an existing template. Then make some bug fixing in this page by resetting the conditionals condition. This is often happen in Flutter Flow when we take a page from template. Okay, for the homepage, I will use it as a check-in and check-out page. A text widget, which will later be converted into a running clock. So the user can actually know when he actually check-in or check-out. Then add the drop-down widget. Then add button for check-in and refresh current location. Then add button to check out. When the user has check in, then this button will be shown. Then at the bottom, I want to display what time the user met this check-in and check-out. And then I will add the page state in this homepage. I will add several page state. First one is time clock. Then minimum distance. Then to side. And then check-in time. And then checkout time. Last one is check-in. I forgot to create a collection for the site. We will create it with the following fields. With name, phone, address, and let alone. Okay, now set to the app state. Okay, this is what the page state looks like. Then I will create another collection named attendance, which contain fields user ref, selfie pic, check-in, checkout, and site. On the homepage, add action when page load, add action query collection to find out whether the login user has been attendance today or not. To find out, we will create a function to get first clock today, which will be used in the filter. Then give name to the output action. And then create a conditional to check whether the query action find data or not. If we find data, then we set the page status for check-in time, taking it from the query set of value. Then we will make the clock run. To make it, add periodic action, start action, and a periodic action, add more action, update page state, time clock, set value, get from current time in global properties. And then set value from page state time clock. Set visibility for this column. If each check-in page state is true, then show this column. For drop-down, we will fill it with site data, okay? First, we will create the site page. Add navbar and choose the icon. As usual, add list view and list style. Set backend query on list view, get from site collection. Set title and subtitle. On list style, take from site name and address. When icon click, we will show the bottom sheet. Create bottom sheet. Get from blank and add container. Add row. Add icon to close this bottom sheet. Then add the contents of the column with the name, phone, and address text field. Then add save button to create a new document of site. Add action on the button. Select create documents, then add field. After that, close the bottom seat. Okay, back to the drop down. Add backend query in the drop down, take it from the query collection side. Unspecify the option, set value of the backend query and select the site name. Create conditional visibility on text widget, select site. So if app state select site is not set, or choose site, I mean. Create a visibility condition on dropdown, display if only the choose site page state is set. Then make conditional visibility on check-in button. So if current distance page state is less than a minimum distance page state. Make conditional visibility on checkout button, show if its check-in page state is false. And then set the value of check-in and check-out from the check-in time and check-out time from the page state. Okay. tried running the app. Select sign up. Okay, the clock is running. We will add a site. Oops, there is no action yet on add icon, select button. And select bottom seat side, running again. Forgot to label, okay, do that later. Now add a new site. Successfully created the site. Now the dropdown is filled with the first site. Now add another site. Now the dropdown is filled with a second site. We adding label to the text field. Add action on dropdown on selected. Create a collection query or query collection to search for collection site with the selected dropdown name. Then update the choose site page state with the output from the query collection. Then we will create a custom action to calculate the distance between the user and the site or the location. Name it with get distance. Then in the return value, set type to double. In the arguments, create two arguments, namely with place one and place two, set type to let long. Then in the dependencies, add dependencies, go locator 10.0.1 and reload the pub spec. Click view boilerplate code and copy, then enter the following code. Also add import. Okay, set the parameter plus one, set with current device location, set parameter two or place two, set with the let long, and the previous action, you know, on the previous action query. Name the output with the distance output. Then add action. Update page state, set current distance taken from distance output. Now add action. When the refresh button is clicked, calculate the distance between the user and the site. Okay, now set let long on each side. I will add it via manage content feature that Flutterflow provide. Edit site, then select location. For the next site, support or piece, we will set let long with 0.0 because in Flutterflow, when the app is the test mode in the browser, it's impossible to get the value from the getting the current location. By default, the value we will get is 0.0. So I will set the second site with 0.0. So the distance will be no matter, right? But if we later run in a real device, our actual device on the Android or iOS, we will get the distance and the let long. Now we try to select a site, then the check-in button will be appear because the distance between the user and site is no matter, right? Less than 300 meter. On check-in button, first we will upload selfie photo to Firebase. After that, click attendance documents. Set user value taken from the authentication. Set selfie pic from the upload file URL. Check-in is from the Firebase server timestamp. Site from the up-down. After that, update the patch state, set each check-in set to true and check-in time is set from the current time. Check for your storage settings. Add action to checkout button. Add conditional if query attended output is filled. Then update checkout column with time from the Firebase server. But if not, then update query check-in output, update checkout column or checkout fields with the time from Firebase server. Then update page state, checkout time with the current time. Okay, now we try to check in. We have successfully created documents. Then we try check in, check out. Then the document is updated. Now make disable condition on checkout button when page state checkout time is set. Okay, now I will edit the data in Firebase so I can do attendance again today. Our function is check if I already check in or not, so I will change the calendar time. and the current distance, I will change the minimum distance to 300. Okay, now we will display the attendance data that the user has met. Create a new page. As usual, add list view and list style. Create a backend query from attendance collection. The value of the site name from title. And subtitle from a check-in time. And now create a bottom sheet to display the tile attendance data. Add image and text fields in it. Then add one parameter to this bottom set, namely a document from the attendance collection. Set the value of the image and text fields from the document's parameter. On the list style, add an action to show the bottom set. Don't forget to pass the parameter with attendance documents. The order in this list view is now chart based on the date of attendance. I will change it based on the latest attendance on the order by. Update Firebase index because we changed the query of the filter the ordering data. Okay, now the order is correct. I'm going to log out and create a new account to try attendance. Okay. Good. Yep. I think that's the end of my video in this time. If you have any question as usual, please feel free to asking in the comment column. Thank you for watching until this time. Thank you.